let's begin with our entertainment news. Tyler Perry is not impressed with Oscar's nomination. American movie director and producer and writer and everything by himself, Tyler Perry has opened up about the 2020 Oscars nomination and how he feels a lot of movies and actors were snubbed. He made this known to TMZ where he stated, "I'm upset, man. J-Lo didn't get nominated. Are you kidding me? J-Lo and Awkwafina didn't get nominated. She should have gotten nominated. That's crazy." Now, this statement by Tyler Perry is in line with a lot of individuals who have scolded the Oscars for some notable shuns in the nomination field. Cynthia Erivo is the only black actress nominated for the category of lead actress in the film Harriet. Other African films like Atlantics were only missing from the best international film category. And stars like Awkwafina, Jennifer Lopez, Lupita Nyong'o, and Beyonce were also snubbed. All right, so big Oscars nomination happening online. Awkwafina was in the film. Oh, I'm trying to remember what the film is called now. I'm sure it'll come to me before the end. But again, similar to Crazy Rich Asians.
Yes, yes.
All Asia, predominantly Asian cast. And so people were like, ah, how come she didn't get nominated? Because I think she even won for Golden Globes. She won Best Female Lead. So that was really nice. And of course, J-Lo for Hustlers. And then something interesting happened with, Issa Rae, Insecure, the writer and stuff. And she was announcing the nominations. And then she was like, I think it was for Best Director category. And she was like, congratulations to all the men. Or the all men category or something like that. But she took a jab. Basically to say that it's only men. And of course, Hustlers, it was a female director. This film, I think it was a female director. So they really thought that, you know, the females would get some light shone on them this year. Of course, J-Lo for Hustlers as well, what she did in that film. So
it's a lot of conversation. People are thinking that it's a gender thing.
It's a race thing.
Because the film for Awkwafina was, you know, predominantly Asian cast as well. And even Cynthia Erivo, yeah, it was nice that she got that. But even with that, there was some drama that,
conversation.
Why is it a black British
so
person?
So are we going to ever get out of this racism, you know, gender stuff? Are we ever going to get out of it?
It's hard. I don't know. It's hard because it feels like, I feel like maybe the Oscar, the Academy, they will feel like on one hand they're taking steps forward because, I mean, the inclusion over the years, I think it has improved compared to what it
used to be before.
Yes.
And this was the same Oscars that the Genevieve Lion had to
too. Yes, it happened with, there was Oscars So White before, I'm sure you guys remember that.
Yes.
And then they felt like they made some progress, did some inclusion.
Let's balance everything up.
Look, it's
so tough. Faladele and OJ, so this is it. So what if, honestly, while dealing with all of this, they felt that these were the people who actually stood out, did very well. But because they have to always bring gender into it and also bring a race into it, so sometimes they have to like bend a bit so that it will look like. I mean, does it always...
I completely agree with what you're saying. What's going on with me? I agree completely because, again, it comes... Okay. If it was a white person who led the cast in Hustlers, would the conversation be the same? Would we still feel that the movie didn't deserve to get talked about in nominations? So it's a tough one because on one hand, you want to please the audience because they will call you out. I mean, feminism is getting louder. Yeah. LGBTI community, everyone's talking.
You see, awards are actually great. It comes with a lot of hard work because you have to put everything into consideration. Yeah. And not everybody would always be satisfied with, awards. People would always complain. No matter what
you can satisfy
do,
everybody.
Even when you have worked so hard, you have thought about everything, you have brought everything into consideration, some people would never still be satisfied.
True.
I like Tyler Perry. I really, really like him and I like his craft. But, I'm just saying that when it comes to awards, that people would never, ever just
we'll talk
be
about Tyler Perry some other time. I have some thoughts.
I think I understand.
That's fine.
Yeah, online.
Yes, let's move on to the next story. Rihanna's team shuts down Shaggy claims of an audition request. Sometime last week, we brought you news that Shaggy rejected the offer to be featured on Rihanna's yet-to-be-released R9 album. Well, the statement by the reggae veteran, Shaggy, claiming he was told to audition to be on Rihanna's project, stirred up conversation online. A member of Rihanna's team, has, however, responded to the claims in a radio interview with Jamaica IRA FM Morning Show. The representative stated, and I quote, "We are working on an album, not a talent show. So why would Rihanna, why would she, Rihanna, require Shaggy or any other artist to audition?" The rep continued, and I quote, "After Rihanna had already gathered all the material for the album, Shaggy contacted her, asking to be part of the album. She explained to him that the album was pretty much completed and they were just working on mixing, mastering and deciding which songs to actually use. However, she invited him to submit some materials so she could see if it fits with the flow of the album. That was by no means asking for an audition. It was more going out of her way to get him on the album," end quote. The rapper and the rep added, and I quote, "We hope Shaggy will come out and let the fans know the real truth, because we all know that the media in general, and especially entertainment media, cannot be trusted. They would twist someone's stories in order to get the most viewers. Rihanna loves the people of Jamaica, she loves the fans of reggae, and she loves reggae music, as her career has proven, and nothing can or will ever change that," end quote.
I love that this is actually being addressed, because I found it very rude if you would ask somebody like Shaggy to come for audition, because I know that, well, young children of these days, what can they do?
Marley.
I'm just saying.
Last week, you guys might remember that last week, I think it was last week we talked
about
it.
Yeah.
And I remember, it was exactly
last week, Thursday.
And I remember saying that I don't think it was a literal case of
line up.
Next! Number 200, come forward. Shaggy, please, do that wasn't me again. I feel like it wasn't literal. So to come out and say this, I'm inclined to maybe believe it. I still think that I see why Shaggy felt a bit insulted. But then it's tough, because the way that creatives work sometimes, you feel like you've already completed, according
project,
to this report at least, you've already completed the project, you've done major work and everything. So anything you're adding at this point is just maybe engineering stuff, maybe.
Yeah.
And so to now come and be like, which is nice. I even think it was nice. It was humble of him to have reached out. But then with reaching out for requests like that, you have to be prepared that it might not always go the way that you want.
Yeah.
It's not necessary that it will always be a yes. So, we'll see how this unfolds.
Yeah.
Maybe he will talk again.
Yeah.
To reply
the
rep.
This person called him out, that guy. Shaggy, come out and say the truth, though. What really happened?
And it's not what...
It's good. I won't say more than that. All right, guys, let's move on. Liam Hemsworth and Gabriella Brooks confirmed relationship. Australian actor Liam Hemsworth has confirmed his romance with, model Gabriella Brooks, as they were recently spotted together while on vacation. Liam Hemsworth, who just, celebrated his 30th birthday, was spotted kissing and publicly displaying affection while on, beach with the 23-year-old model. All right, Faladele, you tell us.
Yes, and according to a close source, Liam feels comfortable with Gabriella and his family approves of her and they really like her, apparently, which is very important to him. Very important to us in Nigeria too. The latest couple were first linked back in December, but fans thought they were just friends as she was still linked to her last boyfriend, Matthew Healy, who is a member of the 1975 English pop rock band. Now, if you would also recall, back in August 2019, Liam Hemsworth announced his split from musician and actress wife, Miley Cyrus, just 8 months after their secret wedding. Okay, so this is happening and I'm excited for Liam. I don't know why I'm excited, Chad, because...
Miley has moved on, so...
Yes, okay, maybe that's why I'm excited. I'm happy for him. And he seems like just, Australians, at least some of the ones I kind of have an idea of, they seem to just be chilled and let me do my life, let me live my... Even the way his brother, Chris Hemsworth, conducts his business. So it just seems like a nice, good boy, let me just go about my business.
So I like when relationships are like this, like they don't come with bags or a baggage. Yeah. Like, this person has not moved on, this person is still in that relationship and still doing this. Even when people thought that, Gabriella was still linked to the boyfriend, the ex-boyfriend, now everything is so clear and it's just so wonderful. People can move on. It shows that, relationships are not actually do or die affairs. Like, you can always just end it with somebody and move on with another person. If you know that that person is not going to, you can't see that person in your future,
move. Can I also ask that this model thing, like, what is it with, musicians and actors and models?
I know,
Leonardo
right?
DiCaprio, his dating history is filled with models.
I know, right?
Future is dating a model, Lori Harvey. They've confirmed it. Liam, a model.
Baby mama
Justin
number.
Bieber married a model. What is going on?
So I think
OJ.
Model, which one?
Which model, Lou? Or Vixen?
Would you like an older one or like...
I don't understand.
Kate Moss?
No, that's she's like too 46. Old, man.
We're just suggesting.
She's too old.
Naomi Campbell? Too old?
Naomi.
She's too old.
Okay. Or because, like, almost everybody done
No, we still have them, Kendall and the rest. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, we're done with the entertainment news.